Hi, I am Dr. René St-Arnaud, Director of Research at Shriners Hospital for Children Canada, affiliated with McGill University. On behalf of my co-authors, it is my privilege to highlight the findings of our article published in the August 2018 issue of the Journal of Clinical Investigation. There is an emerging effort to develop novel strategies to improve bone fracture healing. Traumatic bone injury is a major worldwide public health issue with significant socioeconomic cost. In excess of 10% of bone fractures do not heal properly, and this proportion increases dramatically in patients with metabolic diseases. Thus, any improvement in fracture treatment would be of considerable benefit to patients. My laboratory has a long-standing interest in vitamin D metabolism. It has been suggested that the vitamin D metabolite 24-25-dihydroxyvitamin D could play a role in bone fracture repair, but the mechanism of action has remained elusive. The results presented in our Journal of Clinical Investigation article highlight or identify the molecular mechanisms through which 24-25-dihydroxyvitamin D acts to improve bone fracture healing in vivo. Vitamin D3, which I'll call vitamin D for convenience from now on, is synthesized in the skin upon sunlight irradiation. Vitamin D must be metabolized twice before it can become active and stimulate calcium absorption to regulate mineral ion homeostasis. In the liver, it is first hydroxylated on carbon 25 to yield 25-hydroxyvitamin D, and this metabolite is then further transformed in the kidney by addition of a hydroxyl group at position 1 to become 1,25-dihydroxyvitamin D, which is the hormonal form of the vitamin. In target cell, the cytochrome P450 enzyme, Cyp24a1, hydroxylates the 25-hydroxy D precursor to yield 24,25-dihydroxyvitamin D. Since it diverts the precursor 25-hydroxy D from becoming active, this metabolic route has often been regarded as a degradation pathway, and 24-25-dihydroxyvitamin D is often regarded as an inactive metabolite. But one area where investigators have sought to find a biological role for 24-25-dihydroxyvitamin D is bone fracture repair. My laboratory has previously generated a strain of mice where the enzyme CYP24A1 is inactivated. These mice cannot produce 24-25-dihydroxyvitamin D, and therefore they are an ideal preclinical model to examine the role of this metabolite in mammalian bone fracture repair. When we compared fracture repair between wild-type controls and CYP24A1 deficient mice, we measured a significant reduction in the size of the cartilaginous callus, which is the structure that bridges the fracture gap to stabilize the fracture. When we gave back 24-25 to these animals, we were able to completely rescue this impairment in callus production, but the hormonal form 1,25-dihydroxyvitamin D cannot do this. The impairment in callus size has an impact on the biomechanical properties of bone, which we measured in the three-point binding assay, and exogenous administration of 24-25 can rescue the biomechanical properties of bone. We cloned Fam57b2, a transmembrane protein that binds 24-25-dihydroxy D in a specific and saturable manner. Fam57b2 is preferentially expressed in chondrocytes as well as in skin. In addition to its transmembrane motif, the Fam57b2 protein sequence has similarity to the enzyme of the class ceramide synthases, suggesting potential enzymatic activity. We challenged Fam57b2 with various vitamin D metabolites to examine the result. We measured 24-25-dihydroxyvitamin D dependent production of lactosylceramide by Fam57b2. This reaction shows features of allosteric enzyme regulation. In this mode of control, the allosteric ligand 24-25 binds at a different site than the enzymatic active site to modify its conformation and change the enzymatic activity either by utilizing a different substrate or producing a different product. This allosteric regulation of Fam57b2 was extremely specific and stereoselective, because neither the 25-hydroxy-D precursor, the 1,25-dihydroxyvitamin D hormone, a degradation product, 1,24-25-trihydroxyvitamin D, or the non-natural form of 24-25, which is the 24S-25 epimer, could not induce the synthesis of lactosylceramide. We next produced a strain of mice in which the FAM57B gene was specifically inactivated in chondrocytes. If FAM57B2 is the physiological effector of the 24-25-dihydroxyvitamin D effect, then the model predicts that these mice should also have an impairment in bone fracture healing. And indeed, we measure a reduced callus size in the mice in which the gene is inactivated in chondrocytes. We next treated both strains of mice, the CYP24A1 deficient mice and the FAM57B chondrocyte-specific mutant mice, with lactosylceramide to measure the impact of that strategy. Lactosylceramide was able to rescue the bone, the callus volume, the callus stiffness, so the biomechanical properties, as well as the area of the amount of mineralized cartilage in both mutant strains. Again, if FAM57B2 is the physiological transmitter of the 24-25-dihydroxyvitamin D signal, then the model predicts that 24-25-dihydroxyvitamin D should not be able to rescue the bone fracture impairment in mice that do not have FAM57B in their chondrocytes. And this is what we observe: treatment of FAM57B deficient mice with 24-25-dihydroxyvitamin D is ineffective to rescue the callus volume, the biomechanical properties of the mineralized or the mineralized cartilage area. In summary, we have shown that CYP24A1 and FAM57B2 are part of a common genetic pathway in which production of lactosylceramide by FAM57B2 acts downstream of the 24-25-dihydroxyvitamin D signal to improve bone fracture repair. This represents a novel mechanism of action for a vitamin D molecule, but more importantly, it suggests that treatment with 24-25-dihydroxyvitamin D or lactosylceramide could be used to improve fracture healing in patients. On behalf of my co-authors, I thank you for your attention.